Namaskar, welcome to Lunar Astro. Today's topic, I'm going to show you how you can predict on a blank chart. This is what I always stress on to my students, that use blank chart, using only the energy of the signs, you should be able to predict at least 40 to 45 events. Later on, when you put planets in it, what planets does is, they change the flavor of the event. If you read Bhrigu Saṃhitā, Bhrigu Saṃhitā, only one planet in one house has been discussed. At max, there are charts where there are four planets: Sun, Saturn, Jupiter, Rahu, and Ketu. Only four planets have been placed, and the whole life events has been given. And if you see, there are two similar charts as well. There are a couple of times rishis have used two similar charts, but the results are different. It means in Bhrigu Saṃhitā as well, rishis are using nakshatras. This is why I say, learn the zodiac first. And what I meant by zodiac is, first of all, learn what is in the house, energy of the house, 30 degree span. Learn the energy of the sign. Once you master the energy of the sign, after that, learn the energy of the nakshatra. Because that is 13 degree 20 minutes. The third part is where the Ravan Sahita comes in. It says, learn 3 degree 20 minutes of the sign. So when you know 30 degrees, when you know 13 degree 20 minutes, when you know 3 degree 20 minutes, you're absolutely sure this is the event which is going to happen. So before you move to Shashtyamsha, before you move to Virga charts, before you move to anything else, the first thing you need to do is master to predict on a blank chart. Like why for Scorpion ascendant, there will be one person in the family who will come from outside. He will born and not born in that particular family. He will come from outside. And that particular native will have problems related to blood. Either he will be your wife or through wife's family or your sibling's wife's family, sibling's wife. But that native is the most important native of your life. Why? For Pisces ascendant, the native will harm his kids or his students. The harm can be done in different manners depending on the nakshatra. But the native will harm the kids. Why? For Sagittarius ascendant, just after the marriage, the native will have losses. Why? For Aquarius ascendant, the wife of the native will go out with someone else and suddenly disappear. All these events, I'm not even using the plants. These events will happen. You go and check with these particular rashis. That what particular age this event will happen at what particular intensity. The intensities will differ. But these events will happen. This is what I call the secret of Bhrigu Saṃhitā. Because throughout the Bhrigu Saṃhitā, the way it has been written like there will be one chart, and in some charts, rishis have explained like four complete pages. Another chart, rishis have said only one paragraph. And then you have to read it through why it is happening. Why for Sagittarius ascendant, just after the marriage, the native will have losses in life. So what I've done is, so what I suggest to all the students out there, master the zodiac, learn the 30 degree energy of the sign. Later, come on, 13 degree 20 minutes. Because once you're sure that this is the high energy sign, suppose Aries is a high energy sign. But what that high energy is going to do is going to be decided by Ashwini, Bharani, and Kritika. These three nakshatras are going to tell you how this energy is being used today. So first you learn the sign, later you learn nakshatras, then you move to the nakshatra padas. That is 3 degree 20 minutes. Once you master this, trust me, the predictions, and this is a secret of Bhrigu Saṃhitā. This is a secret to learn the Jyotish. Later on comes the yogas. Yogas comes later on. All those yogas which you speak about, like someone was asking, please tell me the deities of Shashtyamsha. And I had only one question. So even if I tell you this deities of Shashtyamsha, you will never be able to use it until and unless you know what is the role they have to play in that particular sign. Like Yaksha is one of the deities. But Yaksha in a certain part of the zodiac, in the Aries Navanj, in the Aries Rashi, is going to perform beautifully. While in the same sign, it is going to make your life hell. So until and unless you know how to use that energy, because you will never be able to predict. So take my advice, start from the signs. But let us look at the example. What I've done, I've drawn a chart. Okay, this is the Sagittarius ascendant, blank chart without any planets. And you take any of the Sagittarius ascendant, whoever you know, and you match these predictions. The loss in the loss in property at the age of 30 and at the similar time, during the same time, there will be gain in profession. Siblings will have a troubled married life when this native will turn 32 and a half. Good in education will leave birthplace to gain position at the age of 28 and a half. And this will be the bigger change in life. This is a very significant event. At the age of 28 and a half will happen in native's life. Age of 29, marriage or relationship will happen. Age of 32 and a half, native will gain, but after a lot of hard work. This is not, you can't say the native will get it for free. This is a lot of hard work native has to put in. And also there will be a lot of disputes within the office as well. Native's father will lose property after the native was born. And at the age of 33 and a half, when this native will turn 33 and a half or 46 and a half, these ages are very critical for father. Whenever native will get married, he will have losses within 1 year after marriage. Like, let's suppose the native marries today on 27th of April, 27th of March. So from 27th March to 27th March, native will have losses depending on the degree of the chart. Mother will go through hardships at the age of 34 and 46. Also, you see, when I speak about the father, now native father will lose property. This 33 and a half and 46 and a half, this is critical because native father will get verbally, physically abused. Either native father will go through an operation or will get involved in a fight. But these years for Sagittarius ascendant native's father are very critical. Mother will go through hardships, and these are physical hardships, not the mental. At the age of 34 and 46, these are the ages of native. Dasha of Jupiter Sun. See, this is the ascendant Lord Dasha, Jupiter Sun. And Jupiter Mars are both planets. If you see Jupiter Sun, Jupiter Mars, all three planets are benefic for Sagittarius ascendant, but is harmful for this chart for living beings and will live under pressure. See, this is the Lagan Lord Dasha. All the classics says Jupiter Sun Dasha, Jupiter Mars Dasha for Sagittarius ascendants are good. But the native, this is not a good dasha for the living beings and will live, have to live under pressure. Similarly, dasha of Saturn Mercury, there will be skin disease which will happen, and also native will have no work or native will lose his job. Now, this is the interesting one. If native goes for love marriage, his sibling's life will have trouble and native will suffer at the age of 34 from a skin disease. If you notice these points, I mean, these are snapshots for Sagittarius ascendant. If you notice these points, without even planets, we know what is the pattern of native's life, which is going to be, how it is going to progress further. You go to the nakshatra level, I already used nakshatra in that, but for determining the ages, another video of a Chitra Nakshatra Pada 4, where I've shown that if this particular nakshatra pada is rising, what are the events which you can expect in native's life? In this particular case as well, I've used nakshatras to time the events for the activation. It's a similar way, the way it has been written in the Bhrigu Samhita. Because it will be not shown that Rishi will not tell you that I'm using the nakshatra padas here or I'm using nakshatras here. Because he imagines if you're reading yogas right now, you already have the knowledge of all the other things. you already have the knowledge of zodiac, you already have the knowledge of nakshatras, then only you are reading the yogas right now. So to understand the Bhrigu Samhita, you need to master the energy of the signs. Now, book of the day for beginners in astrology, learn and master astrology easily. This is by Sri Sri C.J. Krishna Swamiji, published by Saptarishis publication. Please read it. This is absolute basic book, but worth reading. If you're just starting in astrology, go ahead, read it. But even if you have 10 years of experience in Jyotish, trust me, learn and master the zodiac to understand Bhrigu Samhita, to understand the Chandrakala Nadi, to understand Dhruva Nadi, Tantra Nadi, whichever Nadi you want to understand. So I hope this particular video helps you to determine where you're lacking in predictions, which particular area you need to work on. You need to work on yogas, you need to work on nakshatras, or you need to work on signs. If you need to work on signs, learn what is the energy of that sign, how you can master it. Then you move to nakshatras, 13 degree 20 minutes. Then nakshatra paras, 3 degree 20 minutes. Then you go to the yogas later on. Because if you're directly jumping to yogas and you're missing the first three parts, what is going to happen is you cannot time the events, first of all. Secondly, you do not know what is the result of that yoga. Because if you can predict Jupiter retro in Aquarius, the native will hit a calf. This is the one of the yogas. If you're learning the nakshatra yogas directly or the yogas directly and you're skipping the first three parts, what is going to happen is, first of all, you cannot predict using the yoga because you missed the basics right now. If you only have the knowledge of signs, you do not have the knowledge of nakshatras, you cannot pinpoint the event. Like you will be all, one house has so many things, so many significations. To pinpoint, you need to go to 13 degree 20 minutes and to moreover 3 degree 20 minutes. If you can pinpoint these events, pinpoint that particular part of the zodiac, then you're very sure that this is the way it is going to happen. This is the person who's going to get affected. Whether it will go to the wealth or will come in the living form, one of the things will get affected. So first of all, see where you're lacking, how you can improve it. And I hope you learn something new. I see you guys next time. Like, share, subscribe. And I see you guys next time. Thank you. Bye.